There are people living in unforgiveness. Maybe when you want to pass out from this door and you see another person, you will change your door. Yes, we have come to worship God. There is nothing wrong with it. I emphasize that the two of them did something right. Both of them have come to pray, which is a good thing. There are people living in falsehood. There are people in this congregation and the people of God, they have made their age in the place of work. There are people living in this congregation of the Lord of God that are those workers. There are people that the certificate they are working with is not their own. These are liars. And they read in the scripture that all liars will have their part in the lake of fire. But you never call, you never try them in their hands that these are liars. Let me say that if you tell a lie, for example, I tell you that. Maybe I have a GSM and I said, oh, I'm a liar of God. Why not you know me? That lie can make me fascinated. But if you decide to change your attitude, to change your age, that lie will be permanent lie. And yet the word of God has never been broken. Yet we hear that all comes to us to worship.
He was beating his chest.
The Bible says when he was even praying to God, the Bible says he couldn't lift his head up unto the Lord. What was he doing?
The Bible says he put his head down because he was in the presence of God.
I remember the story of Isaiah. Isaiah, when he came to the presence of God, the first thing he thought, he was not thinking about when he read Isaiah for a summer, chapter 1, chapter 5, he was saying, declare and sanctify the whole people, isn't it? But when he came to the presence of the Lord, he's not looking at everybody and saying, so what is me? Because I'm a man of God. Unclean lips. In the presence of God, we are supposed to be reminded of who we are so that we can see that from God.
I remember the story of Peter. You know, Peter, when Jesus did that miracle of speaking the Bible, he came to the Lord and what did he say? He said, please me and what? For I am his.
In this regard, the tax collector has done what is required of him in the presence of God. And the Bible said, he went up justified more than the world,
more than the Pharisee who came and was bragging about himself.
But what I noticed about the tax collector was that the tax collector was remorseful. He was sorrowful over his sin. But the tax collector,
the tax collector was just beating his chest, so what happened to him?
After he started, he went back and continued being a worker, pastor. Some people will come to the presence of God, they will hear a powerful message, their hearts is prepared. But they will not go to the action of taking the decision and saying, today is the day I'm living my tax collector.
When I remember Zacchaeus, when Zacchaeus had an encounter with Jesus,
Zacchaeus understood that he was unclean. After everything,
the Bible says Zacchaeus stood up and said, well, I will give for half of what I have acquired through what with Jesus in the poor.
If any man, if I have wronged any man, I will give him what?
Thanks for.
This tax collector would have taken a step and behaved like Zacchaeus.
But the tax collector just beat his chest.
As many of us will do this. Our hearts will be on fire because the words of God have life and they have fire.
You remember when Jesus spoke to the men on the road of Emmaus?
They said, as he spoke to us, our heart was on fire. There was a burning of God in us.
And I believe most of you are experiencing this.
Because the Holy Spirit is ministering to you concerning the areas of your life
that you need to correct so that your worship will be acceptable to God.
But after your heart has born and born and born, will you be like this tax collector that beat his chest, oh God, have mercy on me?
But you don't feel like become like Ezekiel by saying, God, I'm tax collector from today, I will not cheat like a tax collector.
Now I'm telling you, this word will stand against you in the day of judgment. You may be a big government functionary. You may be a politician. You may be a director, permanent secretary. You can just be a cleaner. Whatever your status, you need to understand that God is saying to you today that He wants you to worship Him in truth and in spirit. You cannot worship Him just like the Pharisee. You cannot worship him like a tax collector, but you need to worship him truth and spirit. And the purpose of Sunday service is that one week we look at the word of God that is a mirror. We see the wrong things in our lives and we decide to clean them up. The Bible says, whoever hears the word of God and does not do it is like a man who looks at himself in a mirror. After looking at himself in a mirror, he left. And for God, what manner of man is?
Some because of the sinfulness of riches, the sinfulness of position, the pride of life, the lust of the flesh. But remember what Jesus said, what shall it profit a man to gain the whole world and lose his soul?
What I noticed in the church, if those who are considered the Pharisees are condemning others,
discover that there are some who are tax collectors but are also condemning others. Have you noticed that?
If the Pharisees have a moral reason to condemn others, even though they were wrong, then I look around and I found tax collectors also condemning others. This tax collector did not do that. But we find tax collectors. Now, how can someone that say, a lady was saying, that girl is very useless. She sleeps with married men. When I asked her, do you sleep with a married man? She said, that one is a little better. We can stand on our own sins, begin to walk to criticize others. Why will it come for fellowship? Then you see, that is why a man will sing and sing and sing, and nothing happens to the congregation. Because when the Lord looks at the congregation, you see a thing of what? Robbers. For us to worship God in spirit and truth, we need to look at the people. So that when we come, we raise our hands and the Lord will answer us. And there are some when we come for worship, we don't have a purpose. We are just coming. We don't know why we are here. We don't know the reason why we gather. I pray that God will have mercy on us. John chapter 4, verse 23. Remember Jesus with the woman at the well. She was asking about how rooms to worship God. Asking and asking about forms of worship. Today we can ask me the church about so many things. Jesus had to take her back to her life. She can talk theology. She was able to say, our fathers worship God in the mountain. But you say, then the Lord was bringing her back to herself. It's not the form of worship. It's how your life is before God. He said, you are married to us. And he said, those who worship God must worship.